Self-hosting a password manager ensures your precious passwords don't leave your network, but can be available on all your devices. Bitwarden is available for every operating system and web browser you could want. And by self-hosting it, you can even enjoy premium features for free. Let's get started. In this guide, I will be using a Raspberry Pi 3B Plus as the server, Docker for running the Bitwarden software, and Bitwarden RS, which is a much lighter Bitwarden server implementation than the original, so it should run much better on weak devices like Raspberry Pis. We will also create an HTTPS certificate for our Bitwarden server later, so all communication with it is encrypted. I wasn't sure if I should include a basic Raspberry Pi OS installation because most people watching this will probably already have a running Pi, but I don't want to leave anyone behind. So feel free to skip certain steps not relevant to you using the timestamps in the description. This tutorial should work for other server devices as well, you just might have to adjust some steps slightly. To install Raspberry Pi OS on a fresh SD card, download the Raspberry Pi imager from their website raspberrypi.org, launch and install it. Then, in the software, choose Raspberry Pi OS, select your inserted SD card and wait for the imager to finish. The SD card will automatically be ejected, so insert it again. To enable SSH, the secure shell, create a simple file in the boot directory called SSH with no file extension. Make sure file extensions are displayed in Windows Explorer under File, Change Folder and Search Options, or in some cases just Options, the View tab, and the checkmark at Hide Extensions for Known File Types should be disabled. If you will be using a wired connection for the Pi, it should connect automatically. If you need Wi-Fi, a config file will be necessary. Check the link in the description on how to do that. It's easy. Now eject the SD card, insert it in your Pi and connect it to power to boot. After a few minutes it should be booted up so we can connect remotely from Windows. Open the command line or PowerShell and type SSH Pi at and the IP address of your Pi. You can look that up for example in your router or you can try the local domain raspberry.local instead of the IP, sometimes this works already. The default password is Raspberry. Once we are connected, let's install Docker. Docker is a platform that delivers software in easy-to-use packages called containers. You can first try the quick installation script provided by Docker, it's in the description, but it never worked for me on Raspberry Pi, so I will install Docker manually from their web index. The link to the web index again is in the description, you will need to download three packages. I will be choosing the latest version of each. First, the containerd.io package, copy the link, then go back to the command line and type wget and paste the package link by right-clicking. Then press enter to start downloading. Repeat these steps for both other packages, docker ce cli and docker ce. If you now type ls to list the current directory, you should see the downloaded packages. Once you downloaded all three, let's install them. Start with the containerd.io package. Sudo dpkg-i for install, then type the package name. You can use the tab key for autocomplete. After that, install the docker-ce-cli package, then lastly the docker-ce package. Let's also add the user pi to the Docker group by typing sudo usermod dash lowercase a uppercase g docker pi so we can run Docker as non-root. Now restart your Raspberry Pi so Docker recognizes this group change by typing sudo reboot now, then log in again. We now should be able to execute the test container docker run hello-world without root. You can also check the Docker version by typing docker-v. To now download the Bitwarden RS container for Raspberry Pi, run docker pull bitwarden rs /server:raspberry. We could already run it now, but it won't work entirely until we have a working HTTPS certificate for it. Let me show you anyway so you can see what the docker run command would look like. Docker run -d for running the container detached in the background, --name bitwarden, the container name, -v bw-data colon data, a volume mounted from the folder bw-data in our actual file system to the folder data in the container file system, then the port -p 8080 colon 80, mapping the port 8080 to the port 80, and finally the container file bitwardener/server:raspberry. I think it was a mistake reading this out. We should already be able to see the Bitwarden installation in Firefox by going to the Raspberry Pi IP address and the port we specified, 8080. Again, this won't work properly yet. I don't think you can even register an account for now. I will stop the Bitwarden container for now by running docker stop bitwarden and remove it also with docker rm bitwarden. So let's get that HTTPS certificate. I'm assuming you are not already using one, so we will create a new self-signed certificate, but you could also, of course, use something like Let's Encrypt if you know how. The commands for copying can be found at the link in the description. It's basically four steps. First, we create our own root certificate authority key by pasting this command. After setting a passphrase, we have the new CA key file. Keep this file safe, no one but you should have access to it. Second, we create a root CA certificate. Enter the passphrase you just set, then go through the short wizard. You can either enter the respective value or leave the field empty by typing a period. The only value I would definitely set is common name, so you can recognize your certificate easily. Now we have two files. The third step is creating the Bitwarden server key, which generates the file bitwarden.key. Next, create a certificate request file. You will have to go through a similar wizard as before, but it is important to set the common name. Type the domain or the IP address where your server will be reachable, meaning the address of your Pi. This creates the file bitwarden.csr. To be compatible with the most recent versions of Google Chrome, iOS and macOS, we also need to manually create a file called bitwarden.ext by typing nano bitwarden.ext. Many modern devices require this additional security measure. Paste the code provided into the file by right-clicking and change the alt names either to the respective domain or any subdomains of the Raspberry Pi or to its IP address. Save the file in the nano editor by pressing Ctrl O and enter, then exit by pressing Ctrl X. In the last step for the certificate, we sign the Bitwarden certificate with our root CA. The day value specifies how long the certificate will be valid. It's important to know that, for example, Apple only considers certificates valid up to 398 days. Enter your CA passphrase from earlier to confirm, and now we have everything we need. I will now move these certificates to the system folder for certificates. When these certificates expire, you can just repeat these steps to create new ones and replace the old ones. Finally, we can run our Bitwarden container. The command is similar to the one before, but we will specify the volume for our certificates and we will tell Bitwarden which certificates to use with the rocket TLS variable. Once our server is running, the only thing left to do is to tell our devices to trust our certificate authority. So the final step is to install our root CA to all devices and browsers where we want to use Bitwarden. Copy the root certificate from your Pi. There are many ways to do this. I think using FTP is pretty quick. I'll download an FTP software like FileZilla and connect to the Pi. SFTP:// and the IP address. Username is Pi and the password is the same for SSH, by default Raspberry. Find the certificate in the home folder and download it to your PC. Let me show you, for example, how installation works for Firefox. Go to Settings, Privacy and Security, down to Show Certificates, CA Authorities, and on the Authorities tab, click Import, and select your certificate. Check to trust for identifying websites and click OK. Now Firefox and the Firefox browser extension for Bitwarden should accept our certificates and everything should work. To use the Bitwarden browser extension, you will have to specify your custom server. Open the Bitwarden icon, click the gear icon, and type in your server address with HTTPS, of course. Installing it in Chrome is very similar. Go to Settings, Security, and click Manage Certificates. Switch to the tab called Trusted Root Certification Authorities and import your certificate. You may need to restart Chrome before it works correctly. I will also show you how to install certificates on iOS. Get the certificate on the device, for example, with AirDrop, a Wi-Fi transfer app like Documents, or if necessary, email. The certificate just has to be somewhere in the Files app. Go to Settings, General, Profile, and you should see your certificate listed. If it's not listed yet, make sure you can find it in the Files app and try to open it once. Click Install and type in your device's passcode. After that, go to the settings again to General, About, Certificate Trust Settings and enable your certificate. Now both the Bitwarden Web Vault in Safari and the Bitwarden iOS app should work flawlessly. Finally, for good measure, let's do Android as well. It's very simple. Get the certificate on the device. This time I will use snapdrop.net, but you can use any method. Open it using the certificate installer, name it, and select Credential Use, VPN and Apps. That's it! Now the Bitwarden Android app should work as well. I think we have reached the end. Enjoy your new Bitwarden installation. Please let me know in the comments if this was helpful, post any questions, and I will hopefully see you again in a future video.